Super Doppler 4 HD weather forecast.
Stationary front still remains to our north and well to our west, and that's where we have the off and on showers and heavy thunderstorms. Not a lot of severe weather, but mainly just very heavy rain. And of course, these areas are getting hit over and over again, so flash flooding is the main concern along the stationary front for us. We had pop-up showers and some strong thunderstorms, very isolated around the area, just because of the fact we have so much heat and humidity outside right now. But things are quieting down considerably, as you can see on live Super Doppler 4 HD, but it was a different story. You can see we had these very strong thunderstorms fire up and became almost stationary in the western part of Polk County and eventually kind of went right over you folks in Columbus before they weakened. But before they weakened, they did cause some damage. And let's show you the only storm reports we had earlier in the day in McDowell County. You folks in Marion had a little bit of wind damage associated with the thunderstorms, and also over Old Fort, a couple of trees knocked over. And then this thunderstorm just over the last hour in the western part of Polk County. You folks in Columbus, you had a couple of big trees knocked over, which knocked over a couple of power lines, along with marble-sized hail being reported, especially in the northwestern part of Columbus. So there's the thunderstorms. As you can see, they developed, and then they moved, and they weakened, and now they're still in the southeastern part of Polk County. Still some thundershowers going on here, but they're not very strong. Big thunderstorm, but not severe, moved over you folks in Gaffney. That has now weakened and basically has fallen apart. So everything is kind of falling apart except for this little thunderstorm here, trying to regenerate itself just southeast of you folks in Columbus. And then now just a couple of rain showers moving through the central and southern part of Cherokee County. Official high today reached 95 degrees at the JFK International Airport, 5 degrees above the average, and missed the record by 6 degrees, 101 degrees set back in 1986, another hot summer that of 1986. 88 was the high this afternoon at the Asheville Regional Airport, 4 degrees above the average, and missed the record by 8 degrees, 96 degrees set back in 1988. Outside, our light picture on top of Paris Mountain, looking southbound, a little hazy out there. That's downtown Greenville with partly sunny skies, and it is certainly hot outside. Currently 87 degrees in Greenville, 90 in Anderson, 92 in Clemson, upper 80s in Asheville, also in Hendersonville. It's currently 91 degrees in Greenwood, 91 degrees also in Clinton and in Lawrence. It's 91 degrees in Cross Hill. It's 91 in Due West, 93 in Abbeville, 92 currently in Newberry. So hot temperatures outside of the mountains and very warm temperatures in the mountains, unless you've been cooled off briefly by some rain. We had a nice little breeze at 10 to 15 miles per hour to the southwest. They expect the same for tomorrow, making it feel a little bit more comfortable outside, even though dew point temperatures are in the 60s and 70s, making for a heat index of it feels like 100 degrees right now for you folks in Lawrence. So tomorrow morning, stationary front remains off to our north. A slight chance of a pop-up shower or thunderstorm, but nothing's really going to change over the next several days, going even through Friday. These thunderstorms may kind of come in late Friday night into Saturday morning from Tennessee. We'll have to wait and see on that. Isolated thunderstorms around this evening, only a slight chance. Otherwise, for tomorrow, Greenville, Spartanburg, Anderson area, plenty of sunshine, a hot afternoon breeze developing, a high temperature 95 degrees. We'll start off at 80 degrees and quickly warming up to 90 degrees at lunchtime. The Asheville-Hendersonville area for tomorrow, mostly sunny skies, a slight chance of an afternoon thunderstorm, high temperature in the upper 80s to around 90. Start off at 72 degrees and then 84 degrees already at lunchtime. 4-day plus looks like this. As you can see, the heat wave to continue all the way through the weekend with only a slight chance of that afternoon or evening thunderstorm. Our weather pattern changes as we go through next week. The ridge breaks down and temperature is not as hot, but in a better chance of rain.
All right, John. Nice, though. Yeah. Thanks. Yeah.